Hello everybody, this is Kaz from the Scrivener Quick Start channel, and in this video we're going to have a look at the Scrivener 3 for Windows version of dark mode and some cool themes that you can apply to your user interface. This is what the default user interface looks like. Pay particular attention to what the highlight looks like and the squiggly red line alerting you to spelling errors, because these are not always perfectly clear in every theme. To switch to dark mode, go to Windows, Themes, and choose Dark Mode. Every time you switch themes, a window will float up telling you that you have to restart Scrivener for the new theme to come into effect. And I'm going to pause and restart Scrivener for each choice to save you the trouble, but I'm not going to demonstrate every time. So I've closed Scrivener and reopened it. Here's what the new Start or Project Templates window looks like. And when I choose Open Existing Project, I get the default Windows style menu. But when I click on Open, I see my project in the dark interface. Note that you can see all the menus and the highlight clearly, so this is a great option if you like full-on dark mode. Let's go back to Window, Themes. The drop-down menu highlights are nice and clear. Let's try Gray Matter Dark. I like it. I can see all menus and highlights clearly, but the wavy spelling lines are a bit hard to see. But for me, the drop-down menu text is not distinct enough from the editor text. I would have preferred if the containers were a little darker than the editing window, or if they were an outline. Let's try Gray Matter Light. Now, I can't see the text which has been highlighted, but you know you can tweak the highlight color in the Options menu. I'll show you how in the default theme so that there's no confusion. Go to File, Options to bring up the Options menu. Make sure you're in the Appearance tab. In the left-hand sidebar, you choose which part of the interface you want to change the colors for. In this case, the main editor. Open the Colors tab and then choose which specific color you want to change. In this case, the Text Selection background. Click inside the Color Well to bring up the Colors menu. Back in the Gray Matter Light theme, the drop-down menu containers are nice and distinct from the editing window, but I would tweak the highlights. So let's go on to Mellow Yellow. Mellow Yellow is nice and clear, but the drop-down menu is a bit hard to define, and the red is a bit leery for me. So let's click on Ocean. This is my favorite so far. I wouldn't change a thing. Let's try Solarized Dark. I actually have text highlighted here, but you can't see it that well. The highlights in the drop-down menus is great. I really like this theme, dark but not black. Solarized Light is fine and all clear. And then I really like Violet Haze. I just have to mention that when you have nothing selected in the editor, the text in some of the menus doesn't show up at all. But I really like the drop-down menus where you can see the outline clearly. Once you've tweaked your theme, you can save it to a file. Then you can load it from that file or share it with others. They would import it into their Scrivener app and load it from the file. Now, you go and play around with these themes or get on with your work. I'm going to stick to the default theme because when you change the theme, you do so for all projects, and I need my screen to look like the average user's screen. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it's helped you decide whether you prefer the regular interface or want to switch to a dark theme. Subscribe if you want to keep in touch, and here are a couple of videos you might like to try next.